G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is the 26th presentation on the series on the timber framing code, or AS1684. And in this one we're going to look at our bearers. So the rules that we need for bearers, we have rule 4.2.1 and 4.3.1, and they refer to tables 1 to 4, and you'll see why in a second. So rule 4.2.1 says that bearers shall span between the subfloor supports or walls. They may either be single or continuous span over those supports. Where required, bearers shall be levelled, preferably by checking or notching the underside over the supports, or packing of minor deficiency in depth is permitted, providing that packing is a corrosion-resistant, incompressible material over the full area of support. And packing is probably the most preferred method nowadays, just due to the amount of time it takes to actually notch the bearers. Rule 4.3.1 says that the size of the bearers supporting the single or upper story load bearing walls shall be determined from span tables 1 to 4 of supplements. For the floor load width 1200, that's table 1, 2400 is table 2, 3600 is table 3, and 4800 is table 4. So depending on what your floor load width is, then you need to go to the right table. Size of the bearers supporting the lower story of a two-story load-bearing wall shall be determined from tables 33 and 34 if that's applicable to you, 33 being for a full load width of 1800 and 34 being for a full load width of 3600. So if you're doing the lower story of a two-story building, you need to go to 33 or 34. So we have to do some preliminary calcs before we can start our working out our bearers. So you need to know your floor load width. So in this case, I've worked out 2400. If you need to be refreshed on how to work out floor load width, just go back to my video on that, and I'll put a link in the description. And remembering we have a roof load width for this job of 1800. And again, I'll put a link in the description back to the video on that. And I'm going to assume, to start with, a bearer span of 1800 between my piers or my bearer supports. And we'll use that to start our calculations. So I'm going to go to table 2, which is the one I need for floor load width 2400. So that one works out for me, table 2. I'm then going to look at my roof load width. So I had 1500 and my roof load width is 1800, so I have to go for a 4500 roof load width, and I want to try and work continuous span members. So I'm going to go with this side of the table and this column. So then we have span or cantilever. So at the moment I don't have any cantilevers on this job, so I'm just going to look mainly at span, and I want 1800, and I come down here and I've got 1900 there. So my first one that's bigger than 1800. So I could use two 140 by 45s as my bearers, so it would end up being a 140 by 90. Now, again, with my little efficiency rule, if we've got a 45, we are probably more efficient to use a 170 by 35. I'm going to get a bigger span, as you'll see. I'll get a 2 meter span rather than 1900 span out of the same piece of timber. And if I go back to single span side of the table, I can still span 2 meters with my 170 by 35. So I'm going to use 170 by 35. So there we go. Rule 4.2.1 and 4.3.1, they're the ones that talk about bearers. Tables 1 to 4 for the single story or upper story of a two-story construction. And in my case, I'm going to use two 170 by 35s as my bearers.